Hi everyone, and welcome to our Motivation Assist podcast. Today I'm joined again by Maeve. Hi Maeve, and thank you for joining us. And today our topic is Halloween is coming. So we hopefully will be able to give you a few tips. Myself and Maeve are going to recommend some Halloween treats that would be healthy options, and some games, etc., to help you get through Halloween in a healthy way. So I know for treats, I know a lot of listeners out there, Maeve, would be interested in, well, what can I give my children rather than I'm so against chewy sweets and obviously, you know, sweets that are high in sugar, because not only are they going to damage our children's teeth, not only that, they also, I know my kids, when they were younger, particularly at Halloween time, we wouldn't have a lot of rubbish in the house or high sugary foods. So that was the one time that they would have had even a small amount of sugar, and they were hyper. They were absolutely hyper, couldn't get them to bed. So we know, we've talked before about the effects of sugar on insulin. But what Maeve, you might share with us, and I know you did a very helpful blog also on this for us. What healthy things can you recommend to our listeners out there that we could give our kids when they're trick or treating?
Okay. I know children are clever, and we, you know, we can only trick them, tricking being the Halloween kind of buzzword so far. But there's things that they do enjoy. You know, your popcorn, obviously, the kid-sized water bottles, plenty of them, so they're hydrated.
I love that.
Yeah. And then taking the emphasis off sweets, you know, for the younger children, little bottles of bubbles, tattoos, stickers. They love those glow-in-the-dark accessories that you can pick up, you know, cheaply, pencils, markers. And for older children, sugar-free chewing gum. Also, some people, I know somebody who they freeze grapes and they're like sucky sweets, you know, it's another idea.
Oh, very good, yeah.
But there's a few little rules to have around as well, the sweets, is the problem we were discussing these days is the volume of stuff. So
crazy.
Yeah. So people go out and the concept these days is bigger and more is better. It's not. Try to all those people listening, try and go out and buy the better quality sweets and have less of them. There's no need to have a volume. There's absolutely no need to have that many sweets. And when you're handing it out of the door, don't give two big handfuls. You know, the parents will be grateful if you just give a small handful. Don't allow your children to bring their sweets up to their bedroom. It's like screens. You can't monitor when they're up there.
Exactly.
And they'll be munching away for days, won't they? Wrecking their teeth as well. Things like, we were talking about taking the emphasis away from sweets and putting it back onto the old-fashioned games that we enjoyed. We were talking here, and we both, myself and Ashley, have lovely memories of playing, you know, doing pumpkin carving, telling spooky stories, doing Halloween crafts, and Bob the apple, and then yours was pick up a coin in a bowl.
Yeah, we used to put coins into a basin of water and try and suck up the coins. I think, you know, from us talking about it, Maeve, as we were before we started the podcast, for me, Halloween was about the fun. It was about the scariness. It was about the fun of Halloween, playing the games, laughter, and even with the scariness, you know, things we were talking about it earlier about, you know, the ghost in the hot press, or I remember Napoleon, that you had to blindfold somebody and you put your fingers, you say these were his eyes. Remember that? And you dip it with marshmallows or whatever. Yeah. And that I think, again, we've lost that, is what Halloween should really be about. It's certainly, I'd be a bit of a scaredy cat now myself, I must admit. But I think we did try and watch a Halloween movie, myself and my girls, last year. We didn't get to finish it. We were so scared. But the laughs that we had in the house was just, it was amazing. Yeah. And I know you did a blog that you said that it brings us closer together. Humor is the best medicine in life. So it releases, we're always talking about, and you've said it in one of our podcasts, stress. It's a huge trigger for a lot of things, for weight, for cancer. So a good laugh and you know, to scare yourself, laugh at yourself. The other thing which you mentioned is interesting is small amounts, like not to deprive our children. It's not about you can't have, because if we give that negative message, it's like, don't put your hand in the fire. Mm-hmm. You know, curiosity, children are going to go against you and do the opposite. It's human nature, or they're curious. So not to be overly restrictive. Mm-hmm. And even talking to myself, you mentioned there, Maeve, the amounts of food. I was asking one of our girls, or my girls this morning on the way to school, you know, any thoughts on Halloween and, you know, the amount of junk that you get in your bags. Now we live in the country, so we have to go into town to a friend each year. It's tradition, and we go around the neighborhood, and because the girls said we don't get anything here, but we'd play the games. The one thing that's interesting, when we were talking about myself and my girls on the way to school, the amount of junk that you get going around, it's like, as you said, Maeve, a competition. More is the competitions, who can get the most. And one of our girls, Kirsten, said to me, but why can't people just stop then? Stop calling to the doors when, you know, when your bag's a certain amount full. I mean, how simple can it be? She's right. I love, Maeve, you had said it there. What can we use that are non-oral rewards? So I think you mentioned, what did you say? Glow-in-the-dark stickers
accessories,
or something?
That you they are necklaces and bracelets and that kind of thing that children love. Tattoos. Brilliant. You know, and then spend time with the face painting and make it all about that. Like we said, take the emphasis away. And you're right, Aisling, because the parts of your brain that are related to fun and humor are also very closely the same. You're using the same part of your brain when you're scared, strangely enough. They're very, very similar. So scaring yourself silly, basically, is great fun. Jumping out at each other from cupboards and having a bit of crack with the kids. Let's take the emphasis away from sweets and back on that. But as you said, and going back to the restriction thing, is yes, it'll backfire if make too much of a fuss about the sweets. What they could do is separate their sweets into their favorite and not so favorite. And there's a thing that they're doing in the States, that is basically parents are asking the children, can they buy back some of the sweets? So if your child is influenced by monetary value and can be easily bought, that basically you give them some money in exchange for the sweets, and then you decide what you're going to do with those sweets. You might bin them, or you might put them in the freezer for another occasion. You know, it's another idea. But yeah, you're absolutely right. It's all about fun, and it shouldn't be about volume and this excessive. You know, I sound like my mother now when I'm saying that everything has become so excessive, and our culture has become so, it's all about volume. And years ago, you know, we used to say that was like kind of the American way, you know, bigger is better. And unfortunately, we can see that trend happening here. So I think it's up to us as parents to kind of take the control back on that and try and teach our children about moderation.
Absolutely. I'm loving the way you just said I sound like my mother, because I know we do the same. And that's what we're always saying in the clinic. Our habits and behaviors are passed on. So it's really important, I think, you know, that we as parents are an example, because habits and behaviors will be passed on. The reward or the treat, the whole treat thing that you've just said there, I absolutely love it. That it's a non-oral treat, as in the stickers, whatever. And that's something with clients who come into the clinic, find it very hard to work on. When we identify through the mental weight report, that would come up, as you know, Maeve, a lot for people, that food reward is an issue. So associating, for example, you know, I'll have a nice cup of tea and a biscuit now because it's 8 o'clock. I know you've young kids like myself. I put the kids to bed. I've had a hard day. I deserve it. So that is something when we talk about non-oral rewards, we would say to our clients, can you think of 10 things that you can do that make you feel good, that you deserve, but not involving putting something in the mouth? And I know you've been through this too. The reaction is like people can only come up with like 3 or 4. So big time struggle. I love the fact that you said if we can teach our children, start them young to associate things like that, your stickers, or like I know on a Friday, I would have always with our girls, it would have been a magazine. Now I know it costs a fortune and usually they never read the magazine. You've been there that they picked the toy that goes with it. Exactly. But isn't it worth it when you don't have an obese child, or you've tooth decay, or you know, we're teaching them healthy habits and behaviors and attitudes, most importantly. So it's
Yeah, and our language, Aisling, our language around food, as you're saying there, saying to children, like, let's go for a treat after school, and it always being a sweet, you know, the treat, I totally agree with you, it should be a magazine or a hair accessory, or, you know, for a boy, it might be, or a girl who's sporty, we won't be stereotyping anybody here, bringing them to a sports shop and getting new GAA socks or whatever, you know, it shouldn't be all about sweets. And and they can, you know, we can learn from them too, because children are brilliant at giving themselves non-food rewards as well, like they can buzz off, you know, small things that, so we should learn from them also, that, you know, they get little highs throughout the day from giving themselves, you know, fun things and having a giggle or playing a game. And, you know, as grown-ups, we could do it learning, relearning it really again. So let's have fun with our kids at Halloween, and let's play lots of games and scare each other silly, and
and it'll be a great time. Absolutely. Happy Halloween to you, Maeve, and your kids. I hope you have a good one, and this year I think we will definitely try watch a Halloween movie straight through and have some fun. So thank you guys. Happy Halloween to all of you out there. Hopefully again you found the podcast very helpful, and we look forward to covering another hot topic soon.